People often think it's easy to market a biotech business. You might think it's one of the easiest things to do, but you'll soon find out that's not the case. If you don't know what you're doing, biotech marketing can be hard and take a lot of time. This piece has some great tips on how to market your business in a way that attracts customers and keeps them coming back for more. What is a biotechnology company? A biotech company is a business that does study and development in the field of medicine. Scientists have found new medicines, treatments, and medical tools that can cure diseases or make people feel better. They often make medicines with live things like bacteria, viruses, and fungi in them. Most of the time, these medicines are called biopharmaceuticals. These biopharmaceuticals will be sold by biotech companies to doctors and patients in need of a lot of money. In the biotech business, making money means keeping operating costs low and making as much money as possible from sales. What's cool about this business is that you make live things in a lab and then sell them to people as medicines. Biotech is shaped by three things. The first is technology, which affects the creation of new goods. Technology helps make therapies that use biology to solve complicated human problems. A biotech company's operational plan is how it gets its product to market. The working model includes ideas like picking where to build and where to get materials and services from. Core principles and culture are things that help people be the best versions of themselves. The core values help build a culture that makes it easier for people in different departments of an organization to work together, which makes the organization more efficient and effective. 1. Artificial intelligence. With the help of AI in biotech, medical gadgets are getting smarter. For example, machine learning is used in artificial intelligence in healthcare to analyze big data sets and find insights that help doctors make better decisions about their patients. Artificial intelligence can be used to make RNA platforms that can help with research and development, drug discovery, and the creation of new therapies. It can help us move from coming up with ideas to testing them in people faster than ever before. Artificial intelligence can also look for genetic markers in DNA to spot cancers in their early stages. 2. Big data and analytics. For biotech businesses, big data and analytics are becoming more and more important. It helps us find the answers to biological questions and find trends in things like DNA, proteins, and clinical data. Bioinformatics is a part of big data that looks at these huge amounts of information to find new ways to treat or avoid diseases. Data and analytics help put into place strategies for precision medicine and drug discovery projects based on genomics. Big data and analytics are also used by a lot of big drug companies to find new drugs using this technology. 3. Changes to genes. Editing genes is a quick and accurate way to change the way DNA is built. It can come up with treatments for diseases like cancer, HIV/AIDS, and a lot of others. CRISPR-Cas9 is a tool for editing genes that is used to make new treatments for diseases of the bone marrow and leukemia. 4. Precision medicine. Patients have more choices now that precision medicine is being used. It uses a patient's genetic information and information about their lifestyle, environment, and medical background to make a personalized plan for their health care. This can be used to find the causes of genetic illnesses or to find them early. For example, precision medicine has helped us figure out why some genes speed up age and others don't. This has helped us treat Alzheimer's disease. 5. Gene sequencing. We can read a living thing's genetic code by analyzing its DNA. Recent improvements in DNA analysis technology have made it cheaper, so more people can use it. This technology can be used to detect rare diseases, find outbreaks of infectious diseases, and test drug candidates or treatments. 6. Biomanufacturing. Biomanufacturing is a way to turn living things into biological goods. Biomanufacturing helps make traditional manufacturing methods less expensive and complicated, while also improving the quality, yield, and consistency of the products. Gene editing can be used in biomanufacturing, for example, because it is fast, efficient, and makes fewer mistakes than other methods like PCR. 7. Made-up biology. Synthetic biology is a new tool that lets scientists make parts in systems of living things. Synthetic biology makes it possible to make energy, drugs, chemicals, and other chemicals in cells. For example, RNA interference stops or reduces the production of certain proteins that might cause illnesses like Huntington's. Synthetic biology can also be used to make other things, such as energy. They are made by living things whose genes have been changed to make them do more than they normally do. 8. Bioprinting. Bioprinting is a tool that lets us put cells on living things. Bioprinters make organs, skin, bone, and other cells that can be used in transplants. Scientists can use bioink made from human cells, which can be made through biomanufacturing with these machines. They help make new cells or organs or fix ones that are broken. For example, scientists use bioprinting to make cartilage tissue by putting stem cells into the printed structure. 9. Microfluidics. Lab-on-a-chip systems are made with the help of the field of microfluidics. On a very small scale, these chips can do chemical or biological tests on fluids. When compared to normal lab equipment, they work better and cost less. For example, microfluidics has been used to look for biomarkers of cancer during molecular diagnostics. 10. Engineering tissue. Tissue engineering is a tool that lets us turn cells into living tissues. By letting us replace or grow back damaged tissue, they help us find new ways to treat accidents and diseases. For example, grown skin cells can be used in tissue engineering to make skin grafts for people who have been burned. These cells can be grown in the lab and then put into the patient. Marketing plans and services for biotech. 1. Pay attention to product quality. One of the best ways for biotech businesses to do well is to focus on making good products. Because of this, people are willing to pay more for good items and tell their friends about them. For instance, when buying a car, people are willing to pay more for a well-known name with a good reputation than for a brand they have never heard of. 2. Showcase studies of how your goods are used. People might not understand the results of studies, but case studies are easy for them to connect to. You should make deals with organizations that can use your product and then show how those organizations use it. For example, you could work with hospitals or universities to do a case study about how your product helped someone and changed the community. 3. Make the most of your skills in your field. Many biotech businesses are the best at what they do, which can be used to get more people to know about them. For example, you could become an authorized partner or form a strategic partnership with a big tech company like Apple or Google. They can update their goods quickly. People will be more likely to buy your goods because of this. 4. Use videos to show how your goods work. Many people learn best by seeing, so it's important to use movies, infographics, and animations to make the ideas clear. For instance, let's say you want to show how different cells in the body work together to fight sickness. In that case, you could make a diagram that shows how these particular cells behave in different situations.